One of our most highly requested video breakdowns last month was for methylene blue, which is a treatment for individuals who are suffering from methemoglobinemia. Now, methylene blue has a structure that looks like this, and it exerts its effects on our red blood cells, and specifically on a protein within our red blood cells known as hemoglobin. And hemoglobin is necessary to carry oxygen throughout our bodies. At the center of that protein is an element called iron, and that's what allows hemoglobin to bind to oxygen. But iron is in a specific state. It's in a ferrous iron form, or Fe2. But iron can also exist in Fe3, or ferric iron. Now, Fe3, or ferric iron, is not able to bind oxygen. So if Fe3 is present in this structure, hemoglobin now turns into methemoglobin. Without the ability to bind to oxygen, we see increased tissue hypoxia and decreased oxygen moving throughout the body. So our bodies need to help convert Fe3 back to Fe2. And we do have an enzyme called methemoglobin reductase that aids in this process. However, if too much methemoglobin is present, we may need to supplement that activity. And that's where methylene blue can come into play. When methylene blue is administered, it will be converted to leucomethylene blue. Leucomethylene blue is able to donate an electron to Fe3, helping it convert back to Fe2. Therefore, we're taking more methemoglobin that can't bind oxygen and turning it into hemoglobin that can bind oxygen, helping to restore oxygen levels throughout the body. So if you have other ideas of more videos that you want to see broken down, make sure to leave a comment in this video description and stay connected with my channel and with Dane Garvin.